Okay, great. So let's get started. Everyone, thank you for joining us. So, good morning and thank you for joining us today. My name is Dave McPhee, and I'm the Director of 3D Printing Sales here at Cimquest. And with me this morning is Misha, who is a product manager from Kimya.
Hello, everyone.
Before we get started on Kimya's presentation on using static dissipative ABS material, I wanted to take a few minutes and just kind of give you guys kind of a brief overview on our company. Next slide, please. So who are we? So Cimquest is actually, you know what? Let's push forward to one more slide. Yeah. There we go. Thank you so much. Okay. Cimquest is a value-added reseller of hardware and software solutions that are focused specifically on the engineering and manufacturing communities. And we are specialists in those solutions. So including the sales and support for the solutions that we offer, we also provide a wide range of training and consulting, which are basically tailored for unique applications. Next slide, please. So our company was founded in 1990. Therefore, we just celebrated our 33rd year and anniversary in business. And we have 60 employees who, between them, we have a lot of combined engineering and manufacturing experience across multiple industries. So we support customers essentially all over the United States, but the bulk of our business is really concentrated in the Northeast and the Mid-Atlantic states. Next slide, please. So we've been selling and supporting Mastercam CNC software really since day one. And today we are the largest Mastercam reseller globally. Okay. So in addition to Mastercam, which by the way is also the most widely used CNC programming software worldwide, we also provide a complete line of 3D scanning hardware software as well as 3D printers. Next slide, please. And then complementing our additive technology, we also offer solutions that are dedicated for post-processing of those 3D printed parts. So obviously, depending on the application or the scale of production, might be necessary to enhance the surface finish or the aesthetics of those parts. Next slide, please. Okay, thank you. So Cimquest has been involved in 3D printing since 1995, before the terminology was even coined. Okay, so that experience combined with our manufacturing DNA is why we feel we are well positioned to help customers scale from product development through production. And along our journey, we realized that there's no one size fits all when it comes to 3D printing. What you see on the screen right now is a quick infographic that represents eight of the additive, also known as 3D printing technologies that we represent. And the technologies support rapid prototyping to end-use part production for both plastics and metals. And the next slide, please. Okay, so then this is my last slide before I turn it over to you, Misha. Okay, so almost any application for 3D printing can be fit into one of these five buckets, right? So whether it's conceptual models, functional prototypes, manufacturing tools, and just so you know, how I define manufacturing tools is things such as, jigs and fixtures or anything that essentially is used on a shop floor, end-use parts, and then production. The glue that really ties all of these applications or these application buckets together is the materials that we use to print with. Okay, so quite frankly, the technology that we use, in my opinion, is worthless unless the material that you use or the material you use is really up to the task. Okay, so our objective today in hope is that what you'll do is you'll be able to kind of walk away from this presentation with a better understanding of, how and when you should use an ESD-safe material, how that might solve some of your application-specific problems, and, quite frankly, why Kimya is a valued partner of Cimquest. So before I turn the presentation over to Misha, just a little bit of housekeeping. We will be doing Q&A at the end. So in the upper right hand side of your screen, you'll see there's two buttons. There's a chat function, and then there's the question. You can use either or. So as we go along, just put your questions in there. And at the tail end of this, we will do our best to answer your questions. So, Misha, turning it over to you.
Okay, thank you, Dave. So thank you, Dave and Cimquest, for inviting us to present one of our materials today. So this is what we're going to cover today. So we've already done number one with Dave. I'm just going to go through a small presentation on Kimya, our company. Introduction to ESD, what it means, what, you know, how do you measure it? And then, you know, dive deeper into our material, the Kimya ABS-ESD 3D material and applications. Okay, so Kimya, we are a French company, but with an international footprint. So we are part of a group called Armor Group that is present in 20 countries in 4 continents today. So the group is, you know, a century old group. So we were actually created in 1922. Today there are more than 2,450 employees. That's our revenue in 2022 revenue, and we have 42 sites, whether it being industrial sites, so production sites, logistics only, R&D sites, or sometimes just sales offices. So just to go back quickly, the main core business of the Armor Group is in thermal transfer. So there are four different subsidiaries in Armor Group. So the main business is thermal transfer, and then there are other new techs, and Kimya is part of that, one of the new techs. So we are in 3D printing. So Kimya, this is our company. There are about 20 of us in here in Nantes. So our plants are based in France, and we also have a logistics office in the USA. So we produce in France 3D filaments. We have several extrusion lines and also a twin screw extruder for compounding. So we do in-house compounding, and we do all production manufacturing in-house. We also have a 3D printing farm, so with more than 100 printers, FDM printers, in-house. And yeah, we are ISO 9001 certified. We also have a sustainable company rating. That's the gold label that you see there. And we also have responsible purchasing label. So today at Kimya, we have three main services. So we have Kimya Lab, which is our service that offers customized filament formulation and characterization. Kimya Materials, that we're going to talk about today, specifically one material. So it's our range of 3D printing materials, and Kimya Factory. So Kimya Lab is our in-house lab. So it's our group of chemists and technicians that work to really produce a customized solution for a customer. So that customized solution could be a specific color for a 3D filament. It could be just compounding or transforming recycled material, or, you know, a customer's raw material into a 3D filament. It can be creating a filament, you know, working on a filament that has a specific certification, for example. So that's all part of our Kimya Lab services. Kimya Factory service is really the dedicated service that goes into the printers itself. So we have in-house printers in-house, really to help us better develop our materials, because we work on development of profiles especially, and we test all our materials on a different range of printers. There are desktop printers up to industrial printers. So we have Prusas, we have Ultimakers, we have right up to mini factory printers, and also a Stratasys printer. So we have really a wide range of printers to make sure that we can test our materials, work on our profiles, you know, provide profiles for our customers as well. And also when necessary, we do some printing jobs for some key industrial customers that we have today. And then finally, our core business at Kimya is Kimya Materials. So this is our range of high performance and technical 3D filaments, so for FDM printing. I'm just going to show you our catalog, our portfolio today. So we have five ranges of lines of filaments. So basic, flexible, technical, ultra, and remake. So basic is, you know, our basic standard filaments, ASA, ABS, PTG, and also a TUF PLA. Then we have our flexible materials, so a PBA, a TPC, an ESD TPC as well, and a TPU. Then going up the range, we have technical materials. So those are our composite materials or materials that have been, you know, have additives in it. So we have an ABS carbon, ABS Kevlar, we have ABS EC, an ESD that we're talking about today, and also a PTG carbon and some nylon materials. A focus as well on remake line, which is our line of recycled materials. So we have five materials today that are made out of minimum 95% recycled plastic. So we at Kimya, the company actually started out using a recycled material to come up with the first 3D filament. And it's really in our DNA to keep developing and recycling plastic and, you know, reusing plastic to be, you know, giving a second life to plastic by extruding it into a 3D filament and then to print parts with. So today we have five recycled plastic filaments: ABS, high impact PS, a PTG, our PLA, our standard PLA is a recycled PLA, and a TPU. And then finally, we have ultra, what we call the ultra line of materials, which are our high performance, you know, industrial materials, PC, PECs. PEC is really up on the range. You know, it's equivalent to, when it comes to performance, to PEEK, and sometimes even superior to PEEK with our PEC SC. And then we have the ULTEMS and a support material as well as part of our ultra range of 3D filaments. So now I'm going to focus on ESD and then talk about a Kimya ABS-ESD material. So what is ESD? So ESD is for electrostatic dissipation. So what happens is when two objects of different potential come into contact and create friction, some of the surface electrons of the first object are stripped from the atoms and accumulate on the surface of the second object. So the electrons flow from the negatively charged object to the positively charged object, restoring neutrality between the objects. Okay, so when this happens, what you get sometimes is what we call electrostatic discharge, is when there is a sudden discharge of electricity, when there is this flow of electrons. So electrostatic discharge buildup can cause, you know, sparks, of course, which can cause damages to electronic systems. It can even cause fire and can be harmful, you know, so it can affect personal safety hazards, is a personal safety hazard. So when we talk about the ESD market today, of course, ESD problems have magnified, especially during the past 20 years, simply because, you know, we use more and more insulating manufactured fibers and plastics, whether it comes to clothing, furnishing, or, you know, flooring. And of course, because of the increasing use of electronic objects, so the ever-increasing sensitivity of integrated circuits due to smaller components. So components today are getting smaller and smaller, so they're even more fragile within the circuit itself. It has been estimated that damages today that are caused by ESD in purely the electronics industry is estimated between 0.5 to 5 billion euros a year. And in industrial manufacturing plants, the control of static electricity is fundamental for the safety of the personnel and also of the objects. So in whole, electrostatic discharge must be mastered, especially in manufacturing plants. So when we talk about ESD, you know, what is the unit, what is the value, and how do you measure it? So when we're talking about ESD, you talk about surface resistivity. So first, the surface resistance, which is the ratio between the continuous electric potential, so DC voltage, and the current that runs between two electrodes in contact with the surface of a material that is under testing. So that is R, which is the surface resistance. Surface resistivity consists of the resistance experienced by a current along the surface of a material, and it corresponds to the multiplication of the surface resistance by the ratio of the specimen surface dimensions. Okay, so surface resistivity is really intrinsic to the property of the material, and it's represented in ohm per square. So that's what you see here on the slide on the scale. So there are different, a material can be classed in, you know, classified in different groups. So it can either be what we call a conductive material. So that's a material where electrons, like we said before, electrons flow easily. So that's how, you know, you conduct electricity. So electrons flow easily on the surface of the material. And then you have the range in between, which is a bigger range that is called dissipative range. So this is when the charges flow to ground slower and in a more controlled manner to avoid, you know, these sparks. So that's the dissipative range. So that's 10 to the power of 5 to 10 to the power of 11. And then above that, you have what you call insulative materials. So this is, these are materials like plastics, most plastics, that limit the flow of electrons across their surface. So it can't conduct electricity. There are no, you know, there are no flows, or it limits or it blocks the flows of electrons across the surface. Okay. We'll go back into the scale later when we talk about the material. So this is just to give you an idea of, you know, a schematic where you see where the different areas, you know, that have to be managed for ESD, you know, to be ESD safe in a manufacturing plant or a test bench, for example. These are other ESD environments. So this is like synthetic floors. When you go into labs or production sites, you know, sometimes you see this yellow band with this sign on it. That's when you have to be wearing something that, you know, that is ESD safe. When you manipulate electronic cards, of course, you know, you have bracelets, you have attire to be worn. This is another example of a test bench that really has to be protected, and all the whole area has to be ESD safe to avoid damaging the equipment that is being tested. Same goes here. Okay, so now we're going to talk about the Kimya ABS-ESD. So Kimya ABS-ESD is a 3D filament that belongs to the ABS family. So it's part of the styrenic polymer family. So it's an ABS. In which we have added an additive, a chemical additive, to give it this ESD, so electrostatic discharge property. So it is an ABS, so it still has good impact resistance. It is also lightweight. It allows you to print lightweight parts and rigid materials. Today, the Kimya ABS-ESD comes in both the 1.75 diameter and the 2.85 diameter. So I'm going back to the scale just to remind you where, you know, where, how we measure surface resistivity and where the Kimya ABS-ESD stands. So once again, you have conductive, dissipative, and insulative. And so the Kimya ABS-ESD is really a tighter range in the dissipative range. So it's within the dissipative range, but it's really a range where charges are dissipated at a faster rate than just anti-static material. So the other part of the range from 10^5 to 10^7 is what you sometimes see called anti-static, and we are in, you know, in a tighter range, so 10^7 to 10^10, where the charges are dissipated faster in a controlled manner when it comes to surface resistivity. And then of course you have the insulative range, which is above 10^11. So the ESD, so there are other ESD materials, 3D materials that our competitors have out on the market today. Our Kimya ABS-ESD is very different from those other materials that are in the market today, mainly because most of the materials, 99% of the other 3D filaments that are out on the market today that are ESD safe, are materials that use the carbon black additive. So carbon black is a common additive that can be used to give it a conductive or you know, a ESD, you know, depending on the range, ESD safe property. But our additive at Kimya, our ABS-ESD, ESD additive, is not a carbon black additive. It's a chemical additive. Unfortunately, we can't go deeper into the chemical itself, but it's a chemical additive that has its advantages compared to carbon black. So the first one is dynamic percolation. So this means what happens is with the carbon black, the network that is created in the final material depends on the material orientation. So if you have a break in the network of carbon black itself, the properties are not guaranteed. So they are what you call hot and cold spots. So you can get some spots that, you know, have lots of carbon black and some spots that don't. So so that's a disadvantage, because with our ESD additive, the polymeric network is similar to the ABS polymeric network, so it sort of combines together. And the additive is then dissipated evenly within the ABS network itself. So you don't get this hot and cold spots. This carbon black additive also tends to make polymers more rigid, and that therefore affects the mechanical properties, especially impact strength. Whereas with our chemical additive, you don't have, you know, you have minimal impact on the mechanical properties. The particles are not conductive with our material, with our additive, whereas carbon black particles are conductive. So if it's not distributed properly, it can cause damage to electronic objects. A big advantage as well is our ABS-ESD can be colored, whereas carbon black, when it's a carbon black based ESD material, it's only in black. So today we have two colors available. We have it in black and in off-white, our ABS-ESD. But of course, if there is a project where you want a specific color, we can develop it in a different color, depending on the volume, of course, but it can be colored to be, you know, a different color so that it can be, you know, more visible, for example, when it's on a test bench. Using our material, it requires less cleaning, cleaning time. Carbon black requires longer cleaning time because you can get contamination. You can also, it can also cause, carbon black can also cause nozzle abrasion and wear equipment, whereas with our ESD additive, you don't have this issue. The carbon black final material cannot be recyclable, whereas ours is with, you know, this chemical material, chemical additive. Our material allows lighter weight products and also lower outgassing and lower contamination. So this is just to give an idea of the recommended printing settings with our Kimya ABS-ESD. So as I said before, this is a material that can be printed on desktop printers and mid-range, of course, mid-range printers. Today we have profiles available for Ultimaker, of course, Ultimaker in the S series. And we also developed a profile recently released for the Factor 4. So it's one of the few materials that are being launched with the Ultimaker Factor 4. So a profile is already available on Cura, whether it being for the S series or the Factor 4. And it's a material that can be printed in almost all printers out there today, whether it being a Prusa or, you know, a high-end industrial printer, like a 3D Gens as well, for example. Just to give an idea as well of how the printing settings influence or do not influence the ESD property, because this is important. You know, we guarantee 10 to the power of 7 to 10 to the power of 10 range of surface resistivity, but you want to make sure that your printed part, it also has that stable range. So what we did is we wanted to see what the printing settings, how the printing settings influence the surface resistivity of the final printed part. As you can see here, we did a test on the infill percentage density, and you know it showed that the infill density, when it, you know, it varies, has zero impact on the resistivity of the part. So that's good news. We also showed that there is no difference in the extrusion and in the temperature as well. Whether you extrude at 220 to 280, there is constant surface resistivity throughout the different throughout the part, whether it's been printed at a lower temperature or higher temperature. And finally, we also tested it on different infill types, so different patterns, whether it be triangle, concentric or zigzag, and there is no effect on the final surface resistivity of the final part. Okay, so I want to just show you some applications on where printed parts with Kimya ABS-ESD, you know, can be used. So it's, of course, the major ESD users are in the sector of electronic manufacturing and assembling, all explosive environment sectors, so in energy, in the chemistry sector, military, space. In a sector that has that involves fluid handling as well, so automotive, pharmaceutical sector, food sector as well, and then in the clean room supply sector, it's like, you know, in the picture we saw before, you know, when it comes to garments and bracelets and all different types of supplies that have to be ESD safe. So here are some examples, some pictures of parts that could be printed in Kimya ABS-ESD. So this is in the electronic assembly sector, for example. So objects that hold fixtures or racks of cards, shipping containers, storage containers, PCB protectors, you know, edge protectors. Of course, in the semiconductor industry as well, whether it's like wafer holders, wafer carriers, and you know, trays or end effectors. In the automotive industry, so this is linked to the fuel handling industry, there are a lot of different parts that could be printed and that, with ABS-ESD, because it needs that ESD-safe property. These are some examples of ATEX, explosive environment industrial parts, that could be printed in ABS-ESD. So yeah, you know, and in energy chains, bearings, or special parts in these explosive environments. This is one of the use cases that we worked with in Germany for a company that had to do with sealing part in a fuel handling sector, so in the automotive sector. So they needed a part that was used to provide thermal protection between two components in a machine, and the part had to be ESD safe. This is the pair of parts that was printed using an Utsumaker S5. There were more than 300 parts produced, and you know, it using 3D printing, they managed to reduce the material waste by 80% and reduce the cost of the final part as well by 60%. So just to recap, you know, the advantages and the key points regarding our Kimya ABS-ESD. So it's an ESD safe material, thanks to a chemical additive that's added to our ABS material. It's not carbon black based, so you know, once again, for a range of reasons, it can be colored. It does not affect the mechanical properties. It doesn't cause hot and cold spots. It doesn't wear out your printer either. The final part will have good impact resistance. It's a lightweight and rigid material that is very easy to print. Today, it comes in two formats. So the 500 gram format and 2.2 kilos. So you can also have you know, a bigger volume part available in two colors. And once again, if necessary, we can develop via Kimya Lab a specific color. And yeah, this is what we have today. So that's it for me. I don't know if you have any questions.
Sure, so I'll take over here. We have a few questions. So first off, what standard do you use to determine the surface resistivity of the filament?
Yeah, so the surface resistivity is measured, and you know that we guarantee using the ASTM 527 standard. So that's a standard, international standard that is out there that lets you, you know, tells you how to measure the surface resistivity of a printed part that we do on when we do our quality control at Kimya.
Okay, next up we have, is there a support material compatible with the Kimya ABS-ESD?
Yeah, so the ABS-ESD can be printed using our HIPS material. So if you remember in my presentation before, we have a high impact polystyrene that is actually part of a recycled remake line of materials. So that works really well with the ABS-ESD and our other ABS materials as well.
Okay, what is the difference between your Kimya ABS-ESD and the Kimya ABS-EC filament?
So the ABS ESD is what I said for, you know, ESD safe materials, and ABS EC that we have in our catalog today is EC for electrical conductive. So if you remember the scale I showed you before, the Kimya ABS is in the range between 10 to the power of 7 to 10 to the power of 10, and our EC is between 10 to the power of 6 and 10 to the power of 4. So it's in between the dissipative and conductive scale. So it's a material that allows electrons to flow at a faster rate than our ABS ESD material. So for some applications, you know, we have some customers that ask for a specific surface resistivity, so they know that they need the part to be dissipative, but at 10 to the power 5, for example. And if that's the case, we orient them towards the ABS EC because that's closer to the conductive range. And for those who, you know, really need the dissipative property, you use the ABS ESD filament.
All right, so we have a couple more. Next up is, what filler are you adding to your ABS to make it static dissipative, and what does that do to the mechanical properties of the base material?
Yeah, so like I said before, it's not a carbon black filler, it's not a nanotube filler, it's a chemical additive. I can't give you more, it's confidential, I can't give you more information on that. But yeah, that's the filler that we use. And like I said before as well, because of this chemical additive, you know, because it's a chemical additive and not a carbon black, it does not affect the mechanical properties. So it's something that's spread out evenly within the polymeric network of our final material, and it has minimal effect on the mechanical properties of the ABS.
Okay, and the last question we have is, does Kimya have any other 3D printing materials that are ESD safe?
So we have a TPC ESD. So TPC is part of a flexible range of materials. So it's a TPC with a Shore of 91A, and it has the ESD property as well. So yeah, it's a material that is very popular as well. And I know that we have one application of this material in the automotive industry. So yeah, we have a flexible version of an ESD safe material.
Yeah, before you close it out, I just want to comment that both of the materials that Misha just, the material that she presented today, and the one that she just mentioned on the TPC, they're both on our website. So if people are looking for additional information, you know, they can go to the, you know, on our Kimya section of our website, and they basically see the two materials there and request additional information if they want to. Okay. Both the ABS ESD, right? All right, guys, I know the ABS ESD is certified for running on the Ultimaker S series platform, yep. as Misha explained. And again, the new Factor 4, which was just introduced, that's brand new. That was, you know, an industrial Ultimaker that was introduced last Monday, I believe, right?
Yep.
That just hit the market like a little bit more than a week ago. There's already a profile up there on the marketplace for that
yep.
material. And then Misha, the TPC, the ESD TPC, does that also run, is that also certified for Ultimaker? I wasn't sure.
Not yet. We're working on a profile, but not yet. It will be. Yeah.
Okay. Okay, I wasn't sure. But
yeah,
again,
because we haven't tried it on the Factor 4 yet, but, you know, previously with the S-Series, it's always a bit tricky to, because it didn't have a direct drive with flexible materials. But yeah, I think it's something we're going to try printing on the Factor 4, and it might work better.
Yeah, exactly. Exactly,
yep.
Right. So, that's it. I mean, I really want to thank you for your time today. I actually learned a lot. about the material too. So this was good for me, and hopefully some of the folks in our audience got it. So Misha, I want to thank you for participating and giving your presentation. And Evan, I want to thank you too for kind of helping us out with everything. So That said, I want to say thank you all and have a great day.
Thank
Take
you for
care.
having me.
Thanks. Bye-bye.
Bye.